Welcome to the video. This is the last swim, pool swim that is, because I'm doing a lake swim on Saturday before the race. So check out this pool. Woo-wee! So welcome to this week's video. It is race week. It is Thursday. It is close. So we are leaving the YMCA, had a pretty good swim. Like I said, it's gonna be the last pool swim before the race. We're gonna be doing Lucky's open water swim on Saturday. I'm gonna be missing the practice swim at the race in Haines City. I'll be there afterwards checking my bike, but other than that, we're headed to the house. We always have to get a haircut before the race. My hair is kind of long right now. That's why I'm hiding it with a hat. So that way you can be ready for race day. So let's go to Lakeland. All right, I'm in the Ironman tent and everything was just so easy. Checked you in. So they just actually use a QR code, and I forgot it's been a few months since I raced Ironman. So they checked me with a QR code, everything was streamlined. You pretty much go through the stations behind me, you come in, they scan your QR code, check you in, you're all signed up, and then they give you your timer, your chip, whatever. It goes on your ankle, it's pretty easy to get on and off. And then you go to the table behind me here, one of those four. I guess when they're busier, they need more than one. And you get your race numbers, your race swim cap, and they're giving a t-shirt this year, and then they have a giveaway for a backpack. They're doing a raffle. Usually you get a lot of nice swag, but I guess the 70.3, they're definitely cutting back. So it is what it is. I got plenty of backpacks, but we get a t-shirt, and then you get a finisher medal when you finish. So that is it. Now we get to head home, put the stickers on the bike, and get packed up, and then we drop the bike off tomorrow. I think it's 10 to 4 is bike check-in, and I think athlete check-in might be 10 to 5. It's one of those. I could have it backwards, but there's a lot going on here. Let's go down and check out the water, see what maybe the temperature is gonna be, see what's gonna be wetsuit legal. Yeah, I got it. Thank you. Sir? Oh, I got it. You give me one.
I gave you one?
Yeah.
All right.
Buy one, get one, Publix?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm at the water's edge. This is where we're gonna be coming out of the swim on Sunday. See the Roca right there? This right here is where we're gonna run out of the water. The water looks pretty dang clean, and it's like a lake. There's not a bit of wind right now. It's pretty amazing. So then you run up to the transition area, get your bike, rip your wetsuit off if it's wetsuit legal, If it's not, then you just run, jump on your bike, helmet, shoes, and go for it to where my bike's gonna be hung at. And then it's bittersweet because I'm pretty far from the water. I'm probably about 500 yards from the water, so I got a good trot to get to my bike. But then once I get my bike, I'm literally, I don't know, maybe 100 yards to get on the road and get this thing going. So bittersweet, but hey, at least I know where it's at. All right, we're at Lucky's Lake Swim. The other car's behind me. We're doing one more swim until Ironman Haines City tomorrow. Just sneaking one in real quick. Gonna go over and back one time. As you can see behind me, everybody's here and they're just starting. So we gotta hurry up and jump in the water and go for it. All right, we're leaving Lucky's. Lucky's Lake Swim. Everything went good. Had about a 140 pace. Definitely do pretty good with the wetsuit. The wetsuit, I feel like, makes you pretty streamlined. But the swim went great. I really pushed myself going over and then paced myself going back. So the Ironman is going to be an M. So you're gonna go out, hit the top of the M, take a right, come back about 250 yards, cut over to the bottom of the M, go back up to the top right side of the M, and then come back down to home base. So that's where you're gonna be at. So we're gonna go get some breakfast real quick, and we're gonna be dropping the bike off real soon. All right, right behind me is the swim portion. I got a pretty good view. I'm pretty impressed with the view I found. I was just testing my bike out and everything looks great. Look at this. Whew, that is amazing. Check that out. They got everything set up. It's nice. Got all the buoys set up. It's gonna be a great day. Great day, great day. Nice as water is nice and smooth. Like a lake should be. Oh, was it 71?
That's what it said. It's so, a little chillier than 71.
I was at Lucky's this morning and it was 70. So,
okay, so yeah. That's a little better.
Yeah. That's and I know it's under the same aquifer, I'm sure.
Nice and clear, though.
Orlando's only 45 minutes from here, so.
Take that. Nice and clear. Yeah, flat, too. Look
you got to be careful for the water snakes, man.
For the water snakes?
Yeah, watch out for the water snakes.
What about it? Well, how would you want that part?
Swim fast.
Right. Well, what are you gonna do?
I would forget about water snakes. Let's do alligators.
Yeah, alligators too. What are you gonna do about it?
Nah, it's pretty safe though. They got divers in the water. You're everybody's fine. Ain't nothing gonna happen. If something happens, it's on you. It's not no wildlife's gonna get you.
Yeah, no, it's gonna be epic.
Yeah, with 1,000 people out there splashing around, there's nothing.
Heck no, dude. I've been swimming in Lucky's for 15 years and never seen an alligator.
Really?
Oh yeah.
I
don't
know
if
everyone would show
off.
Second largest.
Dang it,
man. Yeah. So this must be a
popular one.
It is a popular one.
Yeah, it's flat.
Also
nice and flat.
Yeah. The run is not quite flat, but.
Couple of hills, it ain't bad.
Well, I love when Ironman says on their website, they'll say flat.
Yeah.
And you look at the elevation gain, and you're like, I wouldn't call that flat where
don't
I go.
Believe
there ain't no
it.
Way.
Don't believe it.
Cool.
much better than I was panicking.
For sure. Plus, look at how flat and calm it
is. Oh.
Yeah, the calmness is that's the only thing I asked for.
Yeah, I'll take that. I've done a few races where they say, like, oh, the current's going to help you, but anytime current helps you, there's always a point at some part of the race where it's not helping you.
Chattanooga, though.
Yeah, I did Chattanooga. It does help you the whole time.
You get a PR on that swim.
Yeah, they're not kidding about that. Yeah. You feel it too when you're like in the zone.
And you go and you meet the heels.
Yeah. Oh, dude, the two loops on the bike. Forget about it.
Did you do it this year?
Last year. I missed this sign up.
Fucking raining. You got on the swim and you got under the bike and for like 3 hours nonstop.
That was Louisville 2018.
Dude, raining. Forget about it.
Plus the wind, and so when you're soaked, and the wind kind of just kind of blowing into you, you're like
Chattanooga the year before, I think, when him and I did it, 2021, you say you do it, or 2020? 2019?
No, I did PCB in 2019, so what, 20? What was COVID?
2020 was COVID, so it must have been 2021?
21, yeah.
So we did it 2021, and it was, what, it was a 94, and they had the second highest DNF rate or whatever.
Yeah, it was, and then there's that bacteria scare.
Yeah.
They're telling the pros. I was up front with Lionel Sanders because I wanted to be up front.
Yeah.
I knew it was going to be a fast
race,
swim.
Folks.
And
have a good race.
They were like, they were whispering to them, like, oh, we might not do the open the swim up because of this feces in the water or something like that. Yeah. And I was like, no way.
He's a cool guy.
Oh, dude, I love that guy. Yeah. I got to meet him. He was there that day. Yeah, I ran into him. Yeah. And I was like, hey, dude, I said, can you give me any advice? He goes, I know what I said. I said, hey, I said, you ever get nervous for a race? He goes, I'm nervous right now. I'm like, what? Let's go.
Yeah,
that like eased my nerves, dude. A pro to say he's nervous and admit it. And I was like,
I don't know if that would calm me down or give me more nerves. Like, if you're nervous, I should be like super.
Nah,
it
hit me the opposite.
Ignorance is bliss.
Yeah. And dude, I hit that pizza. I think I grabbed the whole pie at the end by myself. And and what was it? Swiss rolls?
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, get out, man. Seriously, yeah. Swiss rolls?
Yeah. I was hoping for some more oatmeal cream pies. I couldn't find none of those, but the Swiss rolls were good.
Yeah, dude. I tore those things up.
Yeah.
You're kind of eating. Trying to eat anything.
I did like that bike, though. It was hilly, but I did like
the bike. I did, too.
The run. The Chattanooga.
I walked the run. Dude, I walked the run.
God, those hills, the hill going out, coming back.
Yeah.
And then there's, like, that short little one when you come down that one little turn.
Yeah. But the families were definitely getting it, man. They in the little towns.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
It's a well supported race.
So how far are you guys away? Y'all close by or?
He's St. Pete's, I'm Cincinnati.
Y'all staying here hopefully?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
I'm just in Lakeland. I'm just 30 minutes down the road.
Is that where Sebring is?
No. Sebring is like 3 hours south.
Yeah, y'all did the the one with the circle run.
Yeah, I did that one.
Yeah. Dude, I won in my age group. I was so happy.
So
I got first place.
So did I. It was the first time I ever podium. And they called my name.
Yeah, podium. Yeah, and that chick was up there killing it with a raspy voice. Remember that?
Yeah, that was. Oh my god.
Yeah, dude.
It was a small world. What's your name?
Keith.
Keith. Chris.
Chris. I'm just recording for YouTube.
Oh, cool,
so.
Man.
Guess my name's Aldar.
Yeah. Nice to meet you, bud.
You too.
What number are you for tomorrow?
783. I got to get my race tats on.
Yeah, we're.
And I'm 45 to 50. I finally got over that mark in August.
That's now you're in the sweet spot.
I'm in the sweet spot, dude. That 44 age group, forget about it. Those guys.
30 to 35, 35 to 40, and 40 to 45, man. No, thank you.
Because, of course, you know, you do one and done, but it never works out that way. Now you're chasing Kona after your fourth, fifth race.
Well, maybe not Kona anymore.
I heard. Now, is that true about the ladies only or something? Someone posted.
They're going to alternate every year.
No.
So 1 year you could get Nice or whatever you say, France, and then the next year it's Kona.
Oh, but it will still be men and women.
So they'll do it like this. So, like, let's say 2023, men will be Kona, women will be France.
Okay.
And 2024, men will be France, women will be Kona.
So that is true. It is going to be a...
It's going to be split.
Okay.
And I think it's because Hawaii and Kona have been pushing back so hard.
Yeah.
We don't want all y'all here anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I...
Well, it's starting to get weird.
Turn away money? Get out of here, dude. I mean...
And not just money, like, significant money.
A lot
championships.
Of money,
yeah.
Like, you get
a lot of money. Yeah,
they don't. Yeah, even during COVID, they didn't want you there.
No,
they made everyone.
Well,
quarantine.
I understand COVID, but now like post COVID, like that's got to be a lot of revenue.
That's sort of like tourism, though. It's like what you live off of.
Yeah,
it's got to be the biggest event that island hosts.
Yeah, dude, you could pay all your bills for the whole year.
Yeah,
I mean, if you were like a owner of a shop or
a
restaurant.
Or
yeah, dude, 100%. So, wow, that's going to kill my travel plans.
Yeah, well, you just got to time it up.
Just make sure I get, I win that spot.
Sure get in a good year. Oh, I'm sure they'll probably come up with something where if you win your age group that year, you'll have the option to either do it like that year or the following year. You know what I mean? Like at least to make it more athlete.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah.
Because planning your travel around going to Hawaii versus France is a little different.
Yeah.
I would imagine.
Yeah, because you get to Hawaii in what? Six, 7 hours.
Six,
it's not
seven
bad.
7 hours.
Yeah.
It's still the States. They speak English.
Yeah.
You trust the food and the water.
Yeah. You go to France, you're in trouble.
France, like, you don't know what's going on.
Heck
it's
no,
faster for me to get the cramp in Hawaii.
Alright, welcome to Iron Man Village. It is the day before the race. So it's race eve, if you will. And they just got through with the athlete briefing. And it looks like everybody is rushing in to check their bikes in. We got about 30 minutes before bike check-in closes at 5. So definitely get down here. Some light on the situation here. All right, 5 o'clock in the morning. Well, actually it's 4 o'clock in the morning. Told you a story. But guess what? We're headed to Iron Man Haines City. Let's knock this thing out of the park.
Woo! Go Dad!
All right, so that wraps up race week. So I'm gonna do a post-race video. First off, I'm gonna close this video out. Then I'm going to do a post-race video, just be a one quick video. I'm going to start kind of what led up to the race, a few hours, that's pretty interesting, and then go through the day, how I felt, inside and out, equipment scenarios, good, bad, everything that kind of, you know, went wrong and what went good. I'm gonna give you all that information, and then we're gonna talk about the new bike. I got a video I'm gonna be uploading about the new bike, and that's just what it is. It's a new bike. All the details will be in the video, but I definitely wanted to close this video out first and foremost, and thank everybody for watching this race series, Iron Man Haines City. I don't want to give a lot away, but I will tell you that the race went really well. Didn't get a whole lot of footage of the race, but I did get some good details on, you know, what to do when signing up for the race and what to do when you get there. So as far as that go, it's a pretty good informational video as far as Haines City, Florida goes. A lot of details, which is good. It's like I said before, if I can help that one person, especially starting out, like I said, a sprint's pretty good, and then move up to a half. A lot of people get stuck on the halves, and then they kind of venture into an Ironman, which Ironmans are, they're pretty fun. A lot of work. I will tell you though, the training that I did for the half, which it started out full training, and then I missed the sign up for the full that I was going to do in Ironman Florida, and then I was going to sign up for Ironman Chattanooga, but it just wasn't enough time for travel arrangements. So my race of the year, I would say, would be Ironman Haines City. I PR'd in that race. It was fantastic. I can't wait to get that video out and upload the details, because it's pretty fascinating. Actually, in this video, I did get the chance to talk to some other athletes. You'll see that kind of midway through the video, so I encourage you to check that out. Enjoy that part of this video. Once again, thank you for watching. Smile. See those pearlies? Have fun. And
just talk to that one person about Ironman and inspire them. That's what it's all about, just touching that one person. So I will see you in the next video.